to Fabric Monday, today we'll talk about how to execute many notebooks in parallel. It's common that we may need to execute a loop in a notebook, a loop repeating the same task many times. What if we could execute these tasks in parallel? We can execute in parallel. Let's see how to do this. Here we have a notebook. This notebook is loaded information from two different APIs. We have here two functions, getCategoryIDs and getOrdersByCategoryID. One of the functions is loading the list of product categories, and the other one is loading the list of orders based on the category ID. Let's see how these two functions are being used in the code of the notebook. First, we call the getCategoryIDs to retrieve a list of categories. We transform the result in a data frame. We use the collect to start a loop on the list of categoryIDs. Then, for each categoryID, we call the getOrdersByCategoryID to load the orders for this category. We transform the result in a data frame, add one column, the category ID column, and we save this in a table called orders partitioned by category ID. That's interesting that we save all the results, different results from different category IDs, in the same table. Yes, because I'm using a feature called dynamic partitioning. I wrote about this in this URL that is appearing beside on the screen. The dynamic partitioning is defined by this Spark configuration, partition override mode. And this ensures that when we save a partition in a table, we'll be overwriting only the partition and not the entire table. In this way, I can make the save inside the loop, and I will have the table with all the sets of orders for all categories. One partition will not override the order, of course. Let's execute this notebook and check the result. As a magic trick, this notebook will be executed in seconds during this video. Let's see the result. And that's it. The execution is completed. Let's see how long it took. The main part of the code took 2 minutes and 39 seconds to execute, because it's executing one call after another, one by one. Let's see how we could execute the same task using parallel execution. The first important pattern that we need to understand to use parallel execution is that we need to break this into different notebooks. One notebook with individual tasks that we would like to repeat. In this case, the load of the category ID. And the other notebook triggering the single task multiple times. Let's see how this works. I have here a notebook called load orders. The first cell is receiving as parameter the category ID. Once we receive as parameter the category ID, we have the function which load the orders by the category ID, and we have the sequence calling the function, transforming the result in a data frame and saving the result. Only this. And we have a notebook that once it receives a category ID, it will load the orders for this category ID and save them. Now I need a notebook to trigger this one. This notebook is called Start Order Loading, to trigger the notebook to load each category. So we have the function here which loads the list of category IDs. How do we use this function? The point is, we need to define a JSON structure to call the other notebook multiple times. This JSON structure is called deck. We are defining a deck to make multiple calls to the other notebook. I'm loading the category IDs, to converting the category IDs to a data frame, and to build the deck, I'm using a very interesting structure in PySpark. I can make a for in the data frame and use this for syntax in the middle of the JSON structure to build this JSON for each row in the category IDs data frame. The for is located in the middle of the JSON, meaning that this previous part will be repeated for each different category ID. This previous part is defining the name of the notebook we will execute. This is fixed, but I pass a parameter. The parameter is the category ID. We saw this on the other notebook. The other notebook is expecting a parameter called category ID, and I pass the category ID as parameter. Each task inside this set of activities needs a name. So I'm creating a name for this task, and I'm using the category ID as an identifier for the name of this task. This structure, this JSON structure, will define the parallel execution that we will make. We'll use the statement MS Spark tools notebook run multiple and pass the deck as a parameter, and we'll have our parallel execution. I will clear all the output to be sure everything is empty, and then I will start the parallel execution. One more time, this execution will flow as a pass of magic. But now, the notebook is executing our parallel tasks, executing the deck. See how it works and how it displays the parallel execution. It shows to us each activity that we triggered, and it shows the progress of each activity, the load of each category happening in parallel, the calls to the function happening in parallel. One more time, this execution will complete as a magic trick. And that's it, the notebook execution completed. This example is not a big example. The difference in timing is quite small. 2 minutes and 25 seconds. It's a small difference, a small improvement. But the important is that we executed the tasks in parallel. And we can use this in bigger scenarios to run the notebooks in parallel and make the execution faster. Make the notebook's execution faster. This example that we just saw about loading orders and categories is a perfect example for an article that I wrote some time ago. I wrote an article explaining how to save the result of an API in a JSON file. This is a perfect example for this. We could be saving the result of the API in a JSON file to ensure we keep the result as it arrived, and then after that we start processing this result. Thank you very much for watching, and see you next week.